Hi everyone, welcome back to our new JavaScript project tutorial. And in this JavaScript project we will be creating a simple image slider using JavaScript. So here you guys can see that we have an image in the center, and then we have a border here, and then we have two buttons. One is in our left side and one is in our right side. So if I click on this right side button here, you can see that this image is now changing. And if I now click on this left side button here, you can see that we can see our previous images. And in this JavaScript project we will be creating this simple JavaScript slider. And by creating this JavaScript project we will be learning 6 JavaScript fundamentals like DOM manipulation, controller structures, arrays, arrays dot for each function, JavaScript CSS manipulation, and event listeners. Also, in our previous JavaScript project we have created a simple JavaScript counter. And today I will modify the previous JavaScript code for creating this project. So if you didn't watch our previous JavaScript project, then I will recommend you to check out that project. Link will be given in the top right I button. And in a few moments we will be creating our simple JavaScript image slider. But before we get started, please guys, watch this complete tutorial. Don't skip any part or any second of this video, because these things are important for you. And also, if you guys are new in my channel, then please subscribe this channel, like this video, and press the bell icon for the future videos. And if you guys have any question about this tutorial, about this project, you guys can comment below. And also you guys can comment below which kinds of tutorial you want to see from me from this channel in future. So that's it guys, let's get started. So we are now in our project directory, and here you can see that we have an image folder, and we have an app.js file, index.html file, and a stylesheet. And in this image folder we have all the images which we are going to use for this project. And don't worry guys, I will give you the link of these files in my description. So first let's open our index.html file. So here you can see that we have a simple HTML boilerplate, and here you can see that we have given a title here, and then we have linked our font to some icon link, and then we have linked our style.css file also. And then in the bottom we have linked our app.js file here. So now if I go to our website, here you can see that we have an image here in a box, and then we have two buttons. One is our left button and one is our right button. So first I will create a box in my code, in my HTML code, and inside this HTML code I will put these two buttons, and in our style sheet I will place these images in the center. So now let's go to our HTML. And here first we have to create a div tag, and the class name of this div tag will be image container. That's it. And inside this image container first I will create two buttons. So for creating this button I will take anchor tag, and inside this anchor tag I will not put any href, and then here I will take a class here, and the class name will be button, and then I will take another class name and it will be button left. That's it. And here I will take an icon from our fontawesome icon, so that's why I have added this CDN link from our fontawesome. And for adding this fontawesome icon, let's create a iTag, and here I have to give a class, and the class name would be fasfacartleft. That's it. So here you can see that we have created our first button, and I will now copy this one from here and then paste it here. And this button will be for our right button, so that's why I will change this class name and it will be right. That's it, right here. That's it. And here you can see that we have two buttons, one is left and one is right. So now our HTML part is done. Now we have to go to our style sheet and doing some styling. And in our style sheet here you can see that we have a star, and inside this star we have margin 0, padding 0, and then box size in border box. Now I will take our body here, and then I will give a background color, a yellow background color, and our color code will be this one. Now save and go to our website, and then now refresh. So guys, here you can see that we have now our background color. So now we have to insert an image into our website. So for doing this we have a class here in our HTML which is image container. So I will just copy this image container class from here and then paste it here. That's it. So first I will give a width, and the width will be 60%, That's it. And then I'll give a height, and the height will be 60 VH. That's it. And then I will take our background, and then I will put my image. And for adding this image, I will take URL. That's it. And inside this URL, I have to put my image path file name. So my image is actually inside our image folder, and I want to take the first image. So that's why it will be 1.jpeg. So my images are actually in JPEG format, so that's why I have to take JPEG. And then I want to center this image. Also, if you guys want, you can cover this also, like this one. And then I want to take this as a fixed position. And then I don't want this to be repeat. That's it. Now let's save and go to our website and now refresh. So guys, here you can see that we have our image here. And this image is actually in the top left, and I want this one to be in the center. So for fixing this problem, first let's take a border here, and the border will be 0.5 rem, and the color will be solid, this one. And then I will take a border radius, and our border radius will be 0.5 rem also. And I want to take this position relative, and then I will give a margin so that I can have some space from the top. So that's why it will be 4 rem from top and bottom, and from left and right it will be auto. Now save, go to our website and now refresh. So guys, here you can see that we have our image here. And then I will give a box shadow, and a box shadow will be 10 pixels from X, 10 pixels from Y, and the blur radius will be 35 pixels. Then I want to give a RGBA color, and this color will be 0, 0, 0 and 0.6. Now save and go to our website, and if we now refresh. So guys, here you can see that we have a box shadow underneath this image. So now we have to style our two buttons. One is left button and one is our right button. So for styling these two buttons, first let's go to our style sheet. And then we have to copy our class names. Here you can see that we have a button class. One is our this button left and one is our button right. So I will first style our button left. So that's why I copy this button class name from here, and then paste it here. That's it. So first I will give our position absolute, and then I will give a top value and it will be 50%. Then I will give a left value and it will be 0, and then I will give a background color, and our background color will be this one. That's it. And then I will give a font color, and our font color will be white. And then we have to give a transform, and it will be translate -50% and then -50%. Then we have to give a border, and a border will be 0.2 rem solid, and then the color will be this one. That's it. And then I'll give a font size, and it will be 1.5 rem. Then I will give a padding here, and the padding from everywhere it will be 15 pixels. Let's take a cursor because I want a pointer. That's it. Now save and go to our website and now refresh. So guys, here you can see that we have our left button here. Now I have to style our right button also, like this one. So for doing this, I will just simply copy this one from here and then paste it here. And instead of left, it will be right. And from our transform value, we have to change this value. So I want this button in the right side, so that's why it will be only 50%, and this one will be -50%. And then we have to change this value also, it will be right. That's it. Now save, go to our website and now refresh. So guys, here you can see that now we have our right button also. And from here I want to increase the height of this image. So for doing this, let's go to our image container, and from our mean height I will just increase this one, and it will be 80 VH. Now save, go to our website and now refresh. So guys, here you can see that this image is now taking perfect width and height. So our HTML and our CSS part is also done, and now we have to jump into our JavaScript code. So for doing this, let's go to our app.js file, and here we have to create a function, and inside this function we have to create everything. So first let's create a function, and here inside this function, first I want to bring our images. If I go to my file, here inside this image folder I have all of the images. Now I want these images to be in our JavaScript code. So first I will take a variable. So and for taking this variable, we have to take const, and then the variable will be pictures. That's it. And here I want to create an array, and inside this array I will put all of these images. So let's take an array here, And for creating this array, we have to just give our file names, our image file names. And for simplicity, I have given the name 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And here you can see that we have all these images into our JPEG format. So make sure you have all of these images into the same format. So now let's go to our code. And here our first one will be our 1. Then it will be 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So guys, here you can see that we have our all file names. We have our 6 image. Here you can see that we have 6 image. So that's why we have to put 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 6. That's it. So after importing our all images, now we have to work on our buttons, because whenever I will click on these buttons, then I want to change the image. So for working this button, we have to import these buttons from our HTML to our app.js file. So that's why let's take a const here, and for storing these buttons, let's create a button variable, and it will be buttons. So I want to bring the buttons from our HTML by calling the class names. So that's why it will be document dot query selector all. That's it. And here you can see that we have actually same button names for these two buttons. So I will simply call this button class into our app.js file, and it will be button. That's it. And then now we have to work on our this frame, because whenever I will click on this button, I want to change these images. So that's why I have to take this frame also into our app.js file. So that's why let's take a variable also, and it will be image div. That's it. So this image div is actually inside our index.html file, this one. So now we have to import this one into our app.js file. So that's why it will be document.querySelector. That's it. And then we have to copy this class name from here, which is image container. So copy this one from here, and then go to our app.js file, and then paste it here. That's it. So after this one, now we have to take a value. So now first thing we have to notice, whenever I will click on this button, our image will change. And for adding this change, now I want to take a variable, and then I will give a value for these images. Whenever I will click on this right button, the value will be increased by 1. Whenever I will click on this left button, the value will be decreased by 1. Okay, so that's why we have to initialize a value. And for this one, let's take a let, and it will be counter, and the counter will be a variable, and the value will be 0. That's it. So now we have to work on our functionalities. We have to work on our for.each function. So our this for.each function will work for our buttons, because whenever I will click on this button, our image will change. So that's why we have to take buttons variable. That's it. And then we have to add our for each. And inside this for each, now I want to create a function. So for creating a function, let's take a function here. That's it. And here we will put a argument, and it will be button. That's it. Let's remove this one. That's it. So now let's take our button again, and then I want to add an event listener, and this event listener will only work whenever I will click on this button. So that's why let's take an event listener, and the event listener name will be click. That's it. And whenever I will click on a button, I want to run a function here. So let's take a function again, and here inside this argument it will be e, because it is actually an event listener. So that's why we have to add e. That's it. And then here we have to create some if else statement, because here you can see that we have actually two buttons, and we have to know that which button is pressing by the user. So that's why I want to create a if first, and in our if it will be button. And now I want to recognize which button was actually pressed. And how I can do that? I can do that by actually going into our index.html file and check these classes. If our left button is actually pressed, then we have to call our this button class. And if our right button is pressed, then we have to call our this class. Okay, so that's why let's go to our app.js file. And then I want to go to our index.html file and then take the class name. So that's why it will be class list. And if our class list contains the class name, which one is actually button left for our left button. So copy this one and then paste it here into our app.js file. That's it. So first we have to grab our button, and then we have to go to our index.html file. And then we have to check this button left class name is actually pressed or not. So if this class name is pressed, Then we have to run a condition, and this condition will be counter minus minus. So if our left button was pressed, then I want to decrease the counter value, which is actually now 0. So that's why I will create another if else function here. So let's take a if here, and this time we have to take our counter, and if our counter is less than 0, then we have to decrease the position, we have to decrease the index number of our images. So for doing this, let's take our counter variable again, and then we have to grab our pictures, and then length here, that's it, and this one will be minus 1, that's it. So if our left button was pressed, here you can see that in our array we have 6 value here, and I want to decrease the values by 1. And if this function run, then I want to change the image into our style sheet. Here you can see that I have given an image here, and I want to change this image file name if this function is run. So for doing this, we have to grab our image div here, and then we have to style this one, and which property I want to style. If I go to our style sheet, here you can see that I gave background only, and I want to change this background, I want to change this file, so that's why it will be only background. So background, that's it. And I want to change the image, and so for changing this path file name, we have to take URL, and then here we have to give the image file name, and this image is actually inside our image folder. And then I want to change the images from these values, and now we have to take a dollar sign, that's it. And then I want to grab our pictures, that's it. And this picture will be actually according to our count value, so that's why we have to take our counter here. And then at the last, we have to define our file format, and all of our image is actually in our JPEG file format, so that's why we have to define this one, JPEG. So our button left functionalities is actually done. Now we have to check our button right also. So for button left, I will simply copy this one from here, that's it, and then paste it here. So we have to take our button, and then we have to check the class list. And if our class list contains button right, then I want to change the counter value, and it will be plus plus, that's it. And now I want to change this condition also. And if our counter value is actually greater than our previous counter value, so we have to copy this one from here and then paste it here, that's it. Then our counter will be again 0, that's it. And then we have to change the image also. So for changing this image, we have to take our image div, and then we have to go to our style sheet, and then I want to change the background property. So for changing these images, these things will be also same. So that's it. Now save and go to our website, and if we now refresh, and if we now click here, you can see that I think we have an error in our JavaScript code. This button is not working. So now we have to go to our button here, and here you can see that in our button, this will be document.querySelectorAll. Not query C, we have to change this property, and it will be query selector all, that's it. Now it should work. Now save, go to our website, and if we now refresh again, and now let's click on this right button. Here you can see that if I now click on this right button, this images is now changing. And if I now again click on this left button, here you can see that we can see our previous images. So guys, here you can see that our these two button and this background image is working now. It means our JavaScript code is working. And here you can see that we have created our simple JavaScript image slider. And I hope you guys enjoyed this project. And if you really do, then please subscribe, like this video, and press the bell icon for the future videos. And if you guys have any question about this video, you guys can comment below. So that's it guys, let's see you in our next tutorial.